the universe expands and it expands, and this exponential expansion, we seem to see, the stars seem to be starting to go away from us.
Renowned physicist Roger Penrose has shaken the foundations of cosmology with a groundbreaking revelation, evidence pointing to the existence of a universe preceding our own. This startling discovery challenges conventional notions of the cosmos, inviting us to reevaluate the origins and nature of our existence. In this episode, we'll delve into Penrose's extraordinary findings and the profound implications they hold for our understanding of the multiverse. This is Reveal the Mystery. If you're curious to learn mysteries of the world, space, and beyond, consider subscribing. Science tells us that the universe began with the Big Bang around 13.8 billion years ago. This was when a very tiny and extremely hot bit of energy exploded and created the first building blocks of our universe. Over time, it has expanded into the vast cosmos we see today. So far, scientists have been able to study what happened in the moments just after the Big Bang, but the cause of the Big Bang itself, and what might have come before it, are still mysteries. However, a well-respected physicist named Sir Roger Penrose has put forward a unique idea. He suggests that our universe didn't just appear from nothing, but might be a result of a previous universe. Penrose's theory is based on his study of the earliest radiation in the universe called the cosmic microwave background. This radiation gives us a snapshot of what the early universe was like when it was very hot and full of energy. Penrose and some other scientists noticed some unusual points in this radiation that challenged what we know about the universe. They proposed that these points could be traces of energy from huge black holes in a universe that existed before ours. These black holes were incredibly powerful and could produce energy levels similar to the Big Bang. Penrose had a theory that when he studied very old radiation from the early universe, he found hints that giant black holes from a different universe might have crashed into each other. These black holes were incredibly powerful, and their collision made waves in space that we can still see. Penrose believed that black holes don't just swallow things up. Instead, they break them down into particles of light called photons. These photons exist outside our usual ideas of time and space. Penrose thought that these photons beyond space and time might be the building blocks for a new universe. He imagined that over an incredibly long time, maybe trillions of years, all the stuff in our universe would turn into this kind of energy, like light. This long period from one Big Bang to the endless expansion of a universe, he called an eon. When one eon ends and another begins, the usual rules of space and time might not apply. The start of a new eon might look small to the people in it. Penrose also said that the mysterious point where the Big Bang happened might not be so mysterious. Similar points could exist at the edges of black holes. He thought that the circular patterns we see in the early universe radiation might be very old photons from black holes in the previous universe. These patterns might not look important to most people, but to a scientist, they carry traces of an older universe. Penrose's theory goes against the idea that the universe will collapse into a big crunch and start over with a new Big Bang. Recent discoveries show that the universe is actually expanding faster and faster, not slowing down. This rapid expansion means the big crunch is unlikely. Instead, Penrose believed the universe will keep expanding forever until even black holes break down into light, creating a new universe in a never-ending cycle. Penrose has a theory that's being debated among scientists. He also talked about something called the Fermi paradox, which is quite speculative because there's not much evidence for it. But it's interesting because it suggests that there might be advanced alien civilizations, not only in our universe, but in the universe that came before ours. Penrose thinks that because of his ideas about how the universe works, it could be possible for these advanced civilizations to send messages to each other across different universes. Now let's talk about another fascinating idea, the theory of parallel universes, often called the multiverse theory. This theory says that our universe isn't the only one. Instead, it's part of a huge group of parallel universes, each with its own set of rules and conditions. The idea of multiple universes has been around for a long time, but it became a serious scientific theory in the 20th century. There are a few key ideas behind this theory. quantum mechanics introduces the many worlds interpretation, suggesting that when events have multiple possibilities, the universe splinters into countless parallel realities. This means every conceivable event spawns distinct outcomes in numerous parallel universes. Cosmologist Andre Linder proposed cosmic inflation in the 1980s, positing a swift, early expansion leading to bubble-like universes within a vast cosmic expanse, each potentially governed by different rules. String theory, a complex physics framework, proposes that the universe's basic elements are tiny strings, not points. These vibrating strings may give rise to diverse universes, forming the landscape multiverse. Each universe could possess unique dimensions, particles, and forces, with ours being just one among many potentialities. Let's delve into various types of multiverses posited by the multiverse theory. Firstly, the many worlds interpretation within quantum mechanics suggests that when an event has multiple potential outcomes, the universe fractures, engendering countless parallel realities. These realms offer distinct results for every conceivable occurrence. Then there's the notion of inflationary cosmology, proposing the existence of bubble universes. These cosmic bubbles arise within an expanding cosmic expanse, potentially governed by their unique physical laws and dimensions, akin to isolated islands in a vast cosmic sea. The multiverse theory remains largely theoretical and speculative, lacking direct empirical confirmation. Indirect indications, like peculiar temperature fluctuations in the universe, have been proposed as potential evidence, potentially arising from collisions between our universe and other bubble universes. The theory addresses the fine-tuning problem, acknowledging the remarkable precision of our universe's fundamental rules, essential for life as we know it. Advocates posit that a multitude of universes, each with distinct regulations, may elucidate this apparent fine-tuning. However, the theory confronts challenges. Absence of direct proof for parallel universes leads to reliance on indirect and speculative evidence. Some versions of the theory resist empirical testing, leaning more towards philosophy than empirical science. Moreover, the principle favoring simplicity in explanations prompts critics to question the necessity of an infinite multiverse, advocating its consideration only after exhausting other explanations. Lastly, the simulation hypothesis posits that our entire universe, including all its constituents, constitutes an exceedingly advanced computer simulation crafted by an astute civilization. This analogy likens us to characters in an immense video game where all experiences are products of computer algorithms. This concept gained prominence, particularly due to philosopher Nick Bostrom's 2003 paper, stimulating widespread discussion and debate. Bostrom's main idea is based on three important points that, when put together, make it seem very likely that we might be living in a computer simulation. The first point is that there are very few, if any, advanced civilizations that can make super-realistic simulations of their own history. The second point is that even if these advanced civilizations can make simulations, hardly any of them would actually want to do it. The third point is that if there are beings like us having experiences, most of them are probably in a simulation, not the real world. So, if we put these points together, it means that at least one of them must be true. And if that's the case, it's possible that our reality is just a computer simulation. But it's important to know that this idea is more like a philosophy or theory rather than something proven by science. Still, it's a fascinating idea that makes us think about things like the nature of our minds, the purpose of such a simulation, and who might have created it. The idea of our reality being a computer simulation is intriguing, especially when considering the absence of contact with extraterrestrial life. Some suggest advanced civilizations may prefer simulated worlds over real exploration, potentially explaining the lack of contact with aliens.